Abortion laws less than a month away, the Isle of Man is now on the brink of decriminalising abortion. The abortion reform bill consultation received the most responses ever on the island, where abortion is currently only legal in very limited circumstances. If approved, the bill, which is due for its third reading in the island's parliament on Tuesday, would make the Isle of Man's abortion law more progressive than England and Wales. Well, to discuss this further, I'm joined by Dr. Anthony McCarthy, who's the Director of the Communications and Education at the Society for the Protection of Unborn Children, and Kate Smirthwaite from Abortion Rights UK. Thanks both very much for joining us. Anthony McCarthy, to you first of all. This is a decision, abortion, that a woman makes in conjunction with her doctor. Why should the law be involved?
Well, the law always has been involved because abortion isn't like any other medical operation. It involves the taking of a new human life. It has sometimes devastating consequences. It's often carried out, in fact, nearly always carried out for social or even eugenic reasons, which have nothing to do with medicine. So it's something that, going back to the Hippocratic Oath, has been treated differently. And legislation such as this treats both medicine and law in a very high-handed, or you might say trivialising, manner, because it doesn't take the nature of pregnancy, the nature of new human life, and the nature of good legislation to protect life seriously.
We'll come back to the eugenics line in a moment, but Kate, to you now, this is about offering women a protection, they would argue, and that the law provides that protection, and provides a protection to the unborn child.
Well, I mean, I might be very radical in feeling that women are intelligent, sentient human beings who don't need special protection. They can make their own good decisions about what they want for their lives. The truth is this has been enormously well responded to across the Isle of Man. We've had over 3,500 people writing in, and the very, very vast majority of them have been saying that they want a law that is up to date, that is modern, and that gives women this freedom to choose. And it's very exciting, I think, that we could have an even more progressive law in the Isle of Man, because I'm really optimistic that this can pave the way for the rest of the UK to step up to date, especially Northern Ireland, where abortion is still effectively illegal, but also across the UK, where all sorts of unpleasant and difficult restrictions are in place that mean that women don't have complete freedom to choose about what happens to their own bodies, which is such a fundamental human right that, you know, that we can't really talk about women's rights without getting this first, most basic one right.
Anthony McCarthy, you talked about abortions being carried out for social and eugenics reasons. What about in the case of rape? What's eugenic or social about that? If a woman's been raped, why should she be forced to carry this child?
This legislation doesn't really address rape, but if you're going to talk about rape, you have to ask yourself the question, if abortion is wrong and the taking of a new human life, is the way in which that life was conceived relevant to the status and dignity of the new human person?
But what about the dignity of the woman herself?
Well, the dignity of the woman has been horrifically violated by rape. It is further violated by a deathly destruction of the pregnancy that's resulted. It's a very difficult case. The woman needs support and help to carry on with that pregnancy, rather than the false solution of abortion, which I think creates a further damage. Disability cases, are the disabled now have less and less protection in the Isle of Man, okay. Thanks to this proposal. And there are all sorts of other cases, including an abortion would not be allowed if the child was a woman.
Okay, Anthony McCarthy, we're out of time, I'm afraid. Kate, I know you're shaking your head. We'll continue this debate another.